Good morning to you too, Conrad.
Welcome back to America. How was the flight?
Okay. I think airplanes are starting to lose their glamour for me.
That was fast.
Transatlantic is no joke.
It gets less funny by the year, trust me. So, what's the luggage situation?
Oh yeah, about that. I hope you brought the SUV.
Oh, went shopping, did you?
Hey, you wanted me to be more cosmopolitan. So, I got some new outfits.
I'm looking forward to seeing them.
Bet you are.
There are some things we need to go over, but that can wait until you get through customs.
Just keep it short, okay? We're not in a rush, are we?
Well, just get through customs first.
Okay, hold your horses.
Celia, you got company. Look sharp. Switch to your earplug now.
Excuse me, miss. Could you come with us, please?
Huh? What's going on?
You've been selected for a repatriation interview. This way.
The hell is this?
Don't panic. You were in Italy to track down Redmond on my dime, got it?
What?
You may have found him, too, only his name is Pavoni.
Okay, I hear you.
Well now, Miss Kowalczyk.
So, you know my name, huh? I never did believe in random checks at the airport. You got no right to hold me like this.
I can assure you that the rights of tattooed Americans are not being infringed on here. I am Agent Aikida, and...
of...
Excuse me?
You sure ain't CBP? So who are you an agent of?
Don't get in her face too much yet. There'll be plenty of time for that later.
Of course. I work in an interdepartmental task force out of Quantico. Quite a mouthful, isn't it?
And don't let her fool you now. She's a lot smarter than the badge lets on.
I'd like to ask you some questions concerning your movements in the last year.
Sure. I mean, if I can help with anything.
Now, this trip to New York 4 months ago, can you tell me about that?
Sure. I was there to meet up with my boss, Conrad Coulson. We're security consultants. He's the one who sent me to Europe, too. It was kind of screwy, to be honest.
We'll talk about Europe in a bit, but how do you mean, screwy?
See, there's this guy, or I guess most people would call him a myth, Redmond.
Redmond. Now there's a name.
Ah, see? The power of branding.
The boss has some wild hair up his ass about the guy, so he sent me to find him.
Colorfully put. So tell me then, did you find this Redmond?
Yeah, I think I might have. I don't know if I should talk about it, though, I mean, other than with my boss.
Well, that is a shame. I was really hoping I wouldn't have to hand this over to those Homeland Security boys. Ugh, they're such pests, you know.
What? Are you kidding me?
I almost believe you myself. Keep going.
Huh. So I met with the boss in New York for a conference. You know, massages, hot tub meetings with clients, open bar networking. This is going to suck.
There you are, Celia. Shall we?
Time to face the music. Hey there. Conrad Paulson, my mentor. I think he's gonna flunk me today. Sorry, not Conrad. Redmond. A thief is a brand, Celia. And brands hold power.
Let's talk inside. I've been meaning to see this exhibition for months. The collector I know consulted on it.
It's pretty incredible how much Vegas has changed in just under a century.
Anyway, the buyer has been calling me every 2 hours since yesterday. How did the job go?
It's a funny story, actually.
Funny, yeah. About $500,000 worth of funny, I hope.
Let's take this from the beginning. I did a bit of research on our charming mark. Bogdan Losev, also known as the Moose. Former Russian mob, currently a law-abiding businessman and a collector of vintage motorcycles and cars. He's gone legit for real, apparently. Lives in the Hollywood Hills in a tasteful little stilt house where he was throwing a party. The good news is that getting in was a breeze. When I arrived at the villa, the gate was open, but one of Bogdan's goons was blocking the way.
I gather getting past him wasn't a problem.
Nah, piece of cake. It looks like Bogdan got his old biker buddies to handle the security.
Hold it right there. Where do you think you're going? You trying to sneak in, hoodie girl?
I have a delivery for Mr. Losa for the party.
Go on in, then.
You just waltzed by him, just like that.
Just like that.
Well, maybe you should mint.
Hey.
What?
Come on, we have to check the bike.
Oh, shit, man. All right, I'm coming.
There was a huge crowd at the entrance, and I wasn't dressed for a party, so I chose another way in.
Oh, crap. Piece of shit door stuck again. The rail is bent, I'm telling you.
Nice of that door to get stuck like that.
People were partying hard, some harder than others.
don't sneak around in the dark like that, man. Could have shot you.
The bike's fine.
Getting around those geniuses wasn't too hard. They weren't expecting trouble. I started making my way towards the workshop in the back corner of the garage. It looks like Bogdan got his old biker buddies to handle the security. The elevator was locked. One of the goons had the bike key, so I had to pick his pocket. We may want to make another run at Bogdan later and boost a couple of his cars. The workshop door was locked, but I could have picked that lock with a piece of wire. And there it was, just waiting for someone to ride it into the sunset. So I hopped on the bike, and damn.
I'm really supposed to believe that?
Yeah, that's how it went down, but...
I did have someone keep an eye on the house when you went in, you know.
So you were just enjoying me making an ass of myself?
Frankly, I just wanted to see how creative you'd get with your story. And I was expecting a bit more, to be honest.
Well, screw you.
Yeah. Anyway, let's start from the beginning and give the truth a go this time, hmm?